It was Christian Dangakodo. I'm from, I live around here in London. I was born in Cameroon. Came over to London when I was about 6, 7. I just been playing football, and then, you know, picked up basketball as a hobby at first. I was about 11 when I first started playing ball, basketball, obviously. It was like an after school thing, you know, a hobby. Because at the time I was playing football, and I just got into start playing for Liverpool. So when I started playing basketball, like, everyone was just like, you're crazy, like, don't stop playing football, you know. But I was like, basketball, I just had that feeling that basketball was for me.
That's good, man. Wow, I didn't even know that you...
Yeah.
That's big. How old was you when you played for Liverpool?
I was 11. That's when I was just fresh. I was fresh.
Wow, so you just had talent in you from when you were young?
Yeah. I mean, it was really tough, first of all. It was really tough, like, learning a new sport, you know, because I was really, really good at football. And learning a new sport, that's not really big in England. Like, it was really tough, like, to get. There was a lot of struggles, you know. Like, you don't get a lot of places to play ball, basketball. Like, you get in football, like, you get parks and everything, like, just football pitches everywhere. And basketball, you don't get that. So it was really tough. It was really tough. First of all, when I got to obviously Stockport Park, you know, all my friends from primary school went to like different schools, so I was the only one that went to Stockport Park. And as I was playing football there, like, I made new friends that I was playing football with, and then we all started playing basketball together. So we all transitioned from football to basketball together. So that it was kind of good. It was good. You train twice a day. I mean, it's tough. It's really tough. You have to be mentally and physically, you know, strong to be able to practice twice a day. And you have to put work. I mean, like, it takes a lot of work effort to be able to play at a high level in basketball, you know, because obviously everyone knows basketball is an American sport, so you have to work really hard to be able to play better than the Americans, obviously. Usually morning is like weight training, and then it's like from like 7 in the morning weight training. And then you have to go to school and then come back in the afternoon, have a second training, which is like really tough. You know, after sitting out like for like 5, 6 hours in school, you gotta come back and then just run up and down. So yeah. No, at the moment, I'm not in school no more.
Okay. Yeah. So it's a professional career,
yeah.
All the way, which is what you've always dreamed of, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's been a dream of mine since I was like, you know what I mean? Not just basketball, but because I was playing football before, obviously. It's always been a dream of mine to play like at the top level at, obviously, any sport, anything I do anyways. The Luol Deng Top 50 camp was last year. It's been going on for a couple of years now. I mean, I always wanted to be like involved in the camp, and then when I got a call last year, I mean, I was so excited that I got called for it, and I just told myself when I go there, I have to like make sure everybody knows about me, and that's what I did. I mean, it's a great camp. It's I got called from a coach called Steve Beer. He runs a women's team right here at the Bricks and Rec. And then he just called me and said, you know, like, we really like how you play and all that, and then we would like you to come to the camp. That's how that went. Oh, it was a very intense camp. I mean, you have 50 of the best players from the UK like going at it against each other. So it was up from 8 in the morning till 10 p.m. You know, just like playing basketball like the whole day. You have tests in the morning. Like combined tests, like, you know, sprints, vertical jumps, agility test in the morning, and then you have workouts with like different coaches for about 2 hours, just work out, and then you have three 40 minutes games in one day. usually you play that in one, like, usually you have one game, one 40-minute game in one day, and that's already tough. Imagine you had three of those in one day. So it was a tough camp, but obviously if you want to be the best, you have to go through that. I mean, the camp, how they judge is about, like, your, first of all, your mentality, how you approach the game, how you approach every training session. I mean, I didn't have the best stats in the camp, obviously, but just the way I was, like, making my teammates better, working hard in the drills I was doing, and obviously I was just mentally dialed in everything I was doing, and I think the coaches like that. I think hard work is more important, because I've seen a lot of guys that are really talented, more talented than me, but they don't put the work in. You know, they just think, oh, because I'm talented, I'm gonna be able to, you know, get there. But I've learned that hard work beats talent. If talent refuses to work, you know, like, my coaches always put that into me, that you have to put the work in. Like, you're talented, but there's people that are more talented than you, but they don't want to work. So you have to be able to surpass them. You have to put the work in. So that's how I've been since. Just work.
Okay. So would you say that it's your talent or your kind of you know, your mind frame that's got you to where you are, because you've had a pretty successful career. Not many people can say they played for Liverpool Football Club and then gone on to play pro basketball. So how have you managed to do both of them?
I think it's just like my work ethic, you know. I just like to work, you know. It's just like, I know that I've seen like the top professional players, how they work, like their stories, how they got there, you know. And I think I want to be like one of those guys, you know, that put the work in, and to get where they at, and then, you know, to be able to tell a story how I got there, how hard work can get you to, like, to all these places. I mean, before I left, I actually left London in like year 9, didn't do GCSEs. So like, before I left, like, my parents like were saying no, like, you have to stay in school. But I just told my mom, you're like, you know, like, I have to do this. I can't be here in London like doing nothing, you know. Because obviously I already left football, so Boston was like life now, you know. So, you know, I was 14, like, in a new environment, different country, no one really speak English, you know. So it was really tough for me to be there without family, friends, you know. I mean, you know, back in the day it was like, you know, like, we had BBMs and all that stuff. So I'll be looking at my phone, like, all my friends be going to the cinemas and stuff, and I'm here in my room waiting for practice to start, you know. So like, it was really tough.
So at such a young age, like, how did you have that mental capacity to tell yourself that, you know what, this is what I want to do? Many people have, you know, talents or they're in positions where they can kind of go places at a young stage, but they let other distractions, like their friends wanting to go to the mall, wanting to be in gangs and stuff, distract them. What was it that kind of allowed you to have that mental capacity?
I mean, I've seen her go through a lot of things, you know. Feel like a tough time. I mean, she done a lot for me. She always been supporting me. So, like, as being young, I always had that mentality that I'm gonna do whatever it takes, you know, to put my mom in, like, in good situation. So, whatever, I just told myself, whatever it takes, I'm willing to do it. I mean, right now, I just came back from Germany. My season ended. After that, I was the national team, Great Britain under 20s, at the European Championship. So I mean I had a pretty good summer. I mean, Germany, I was there for a year. That was a great experience for me, you know, playing with like Americans, like NBA talents and all that. It was tough, but, you know, like I said before, like, I'm not scared of challenges, I'm of hard work. Like, like I approach everything like with a you know, hustler mentality, if I may say. I used to get nervous, but now it's just like, it's just fun for me now, you know what I'm saying? It's just like, it's not, I mean, they play basketball like I play basketball, you know? It's like, it's the same sport. We all do the same thing. So, like, I used to get nervous before because, obviously, when I first, like, went overseas, like, nobody knew me, really. So, I seen all these other players that they talk about on the blogs and all that. So when I played against, I was a bit nervous, like, oh, okay, that's the guy I saw on the internet the other day, you know. But now, like, I can say I'm one of those guys now. So I don't really get nervous no more. I think it was in 2013, when I was in the European Championship in Latvia with the under 18s England national team. And then, I mean, we had a great game against Spain. We had a great game against Spain. I mean, after that, I just like had like agents, like coaches from abroad, like just messaging me, telling me how, you know, how they really like how I play and all that. So from that day, I think that's when like I kind of like play it through. I mean, only thing I would say, you know, just, it's all about believing in yourself, you know. It's all about believing in yourself, having the work ethic, having that go-getter, you know, mentality. Like, whatever you want to do, you can do it. You just have to believe in yourself. Like, don't let no one tell you that you can't, you know, do that because someone else is better than you and all of that. Because I had people telling me, you know, like, you're really good at football, so don't do basketball because, you know, no one in England plays basketball really. So I just had that belief. You know, you have to believe in yourself. Whatever you do, put 110% in. You know, don't go in put like 50 and say, oh, okay, because I know this guy, he might make me go here. You know, you have to have that belief and then put 110% in everything you do. Ultimate goal is to play in the NBA. You know, I still have a couple more years to improve, you know, to work on my game. So yeah, that's the ultimate goal, to get to the NBA.